Hello, everyone. Yesterday, Eliana Rubashkyn, a.k.a. Ellie Goldberstein, a.k.a. Louise Alexander Bermudez Rubashkyn, appeared in court to enter a plea in response to new charges, and SimonTV attended the hearing. Rubashkyn is a Green Party activist. He came to public notoriety when he assaulted Kelly J. Keen Minchell, a.k.a. Posey Parker, and Tania Sturt at a women's rights rally in Auckland's Albert Park 15 months ago. It was an act of premeditated political violence. I captured viral footage of the incident. This is what he did. Rubashkyn is prominent in left-wing political circles. Here he is with three current Green Party members of parliament. The political violence he perpetrated was widely celebrated by the far left, and Green Party co-leader Chloe Swarbrick appeared on national television in the subsequent days and appeared to justify his actions.
Just on what happened with Eliana, what you're talking about there is somebody who came to this country as an asylum seeker, as somebody who had been persecuted in their country as an intersex trans woman by virtue of who she is, who came to this place because it was a safe country. She has had the direct experience of the kind of rhetoric that we are talking about escalating into violence. So I just wanted to provide that context.
Following Swarbrick's disconcerting interview, Rubashkyn was feted in sympathetic media interviews by the far-left vestigial mainstream media, including New Zealand's Stuff, Radio New Zealand, Pink News in the UK. There was a lot of media coverage. And of course, Rubashkyn made guest appearances on Rainbow podcasts, dining out on the worldwide notoriety he had gained from engaging in premeditated political violence.
Then I convinced them I needed to go inside the rotunda, because inside the rotunda it was only Tania.
Yeah.
It was this other lady. She's part of the far right media.
In 15 months since those assaults in Albert Park, Rubashkyn has been a busy boy, harassing his victims online with social media posts like this one, and running around in central Auckland with what appears to be a machete, defacing the hoardings of politicians he doesn't like prior to the last general election, then posting video clips of it to social media for his comrades to enjoy.
Got this thing. Slay. So slay. So pretty. I got these stickers on, like, look sharp. So it's not considered vandalism. You know these dames, they're trying to chase the tranny. So you have to do it. Oh, look. She, like, you see, she wants genocide. I can see she wants genocide. She tastes genocide. And I can show her that if you vote for her, you will get what she wants. So it's cute. Oh, she's so cute. She wants just to kill people. So cute. Such a good Christian. And then, oh, these ones are like fake, just in case somebody asks, you know? It's not real. But you know, it's just reminders. Reminders. Reminders.
Reminders. Maintaining his innocence to the charges, Rubashkyn changed his plea to guilty for these assaults just 3 weeks ago. He's due to be sentenced at Auckland District Court on September the 2nd, and his defence counsel indicated Rubashkyn intends to apply for a discharge without conviction. One of his victims, Tania Sturt, has told the police prosecution that she strenuously objects to a discharge. It will be very interesting to see if the police listen to the voice of the female victim of premeditated political violence and oppose the discharge without conviction application. Either way, also, if the New Zealand justice system in its infinite wisdom grants it. Which brings us to yesterday's appearance. 2 weeks ago, he arrived at court with his supporters to answer two charges, one of dangerous driving and the other of assault with a blunt instrument. Rubashkyn entered a plea of not guilty to both charges. A judge-alone trial is set down for the 20th of November. The defence indicated they intend to call an expert witness who, it is understood, is a medical practitioner. The other matter the judge considered was my application to photograph Rubashkyn standing in the dock, an image I believe the world deserves to see. Rubashkyn's defence counsel strongly objected to my application, and the judge declined it due to some technicalities around my media accreditation. Following numerous interviews and podcast appearances, Rubashkyn is suddenly a lot less willing to be photographed. I'm going through the process to ensure my accreditation is in place, and I've informed other media of the situation, some of whom I understand will also be lodging applications to photograph in court. In my estimation, Judge Simon Lance is a decent fellow committed to the concept of open justice, so I have little doubt that these media applications will be granted. So in summary, Rubashkyn has pleaded guilty to the two initial charges of assault and will apply for a discharge without conviction on the 2nd of September. He has pled most recently not guilty to the subsequent charges of assault with a blunt instrument and dangerous driving, for which he will go to trial on the 20th of November. Thank you for tuning into Simon TV. See you next time. Goodbye.